We're at our 45 white oak project, and as you can see behind me, framing is underway. A couple things that we're faced with on this project is, number one, the project site is really tight. What's critical to us, you know, number one, tight street, tight site. So working with a trade partner such as Koopman Lumber to make sure that we're scheduling deliveries to come in a way that is less impactful on the street and less impactful on the site. Despite how big this driveway is, which can probably hold 15 normal sized cars, it gets filled up really quickly with lumber and material. You can see that we got our steel on site and we got a plethora of LVL stock being stocked up here. This is all for the second floor. As you can see behind me, framing is completely underway. We took you guys down to Cape Cod Panel where all of these walls were manufactured. The floor system itself was all framed traditionally on site. Everything was stick framed. We set our ledger across the entire inside of the foundation, anchored that to the foundation, set all of our floor joists, set our subfloor deck, and then we took delivery of the wall panels. And what you see behind me is a product of just a day and a half of work. So most of these walls went up yesterday, and today they're spending their time getting everything situated, level, plumb, and square. We have our outdoor living space, and then we have our indoor living space, and then we have our entry, and then what we have is a pantry on that far end. I'm here, I'm making sure that there's no questions that are coming up, which they're really eliminated because we're spending all that time with someone like Cape Cod Panel, and everything's been modeled in 3D. Everything's been figured out. There's very little for interpretation on site, but we have very minor things that come up, and usually they're just clarifying questions. And generally speaking, if I wasn't here, they would proceed in a way that makes sense anyway. This here is outdoor space, but it's above indoor living space below. This is a full basement here, which is additional living room in the basement. This needs to be waterproof. So I actually had our roofer on site or waterproofer on site this morning, looking at this, putting a plan together. So once we get up to the roof on the main house, we'll be fully protected here, and we can actually start getting this waterproof. And same thing with the entry over here. So the entryway, as we're looking at it, is set in and recessed. And then on the left there is our full height solid cedar door. And then to the facing the street, that's actually a giant window that has a pass through all the way to the backyard. But that recessed section is all above garage and living space. So really, really critical that we get that waterproof. That steel that you saw down below, one of those beams is for this. You can actually start to see where that bridge is gonna be. There'll be a planter in the front and then a bridge that brings you across to the other side of the yard. And the other piece of steel actually goes in the second floor. So I mentioned that material was showing up for the second floor. These guys are gonna be ready to start setting the second floor tomorrow. I had mentioned this when we were down the Cape, and I was talking about this giant opening, and I was like, holy crap, this opening is massive. And as you walk around, you see giant openings on this building, and they're all going to be glass. And this one right here is just under 20 feet wide. And it really gives you the view into what this backyard is gonna look like and how it interacts with your indoor living room. What I love about this is that the first floor is really truly open. There's all of these pass-throughs. You have view from backyard to front yard, and again at the entryway, and even over here where the kitchen will be. This looks into the kitchen, but has a floor-to-ceiling window on the left, giant glass lift slide on both ends. Really opening yourself up into the backyard, into nature, but not really sucking in, you know, the view of, it's probably a terrible way to put it, but not really highlighting the view of other buildings. It's really, you know, the house is situated in a way that has a tremendous amount of glass, but done so in a way that is more private than you would suspect. With that being said, when we get to the second floor, you'll start to see that our openings are all punched openings, meaning that they're smaller windows, not so much floor to ceiling glass. As we work our way over here, this will be the outdoor kitchen. So if you guys remember, there was two piers here that are pinned down to the ledge. This will be a full deck. We have a tricky deck, a tricky way that we're gonna frame this, and we'll come back to that later, because deck orientation of the boards is really critical, because inside we have our flooring running in this direction. We actually want it to come out the same way out here, and rather than switching the joist direction, you'll see how we do that. But what I wanted to point out is, if you look inside, we have what we're calling, you know, our envelope wall, which is a 2x6 wall. So I actually will hop up here and I'll show you. So essentially what we have, if I were to walk through it, is we have our exterior half inch plywood, we have our 2x6 wall. This 2x6 wall will get fully insulated with Rockwool Comfort Bat. So that entire cavity gets filled. And then we have our 2x3 service cavity. This 2x6 wall cavity filled insulation detail or envelope is what you typically would see. In addition to that, we're gonna actually have 5 inches of exterior insulation, which is the comfort board from Rockwool, which is continuous from the foundation all the way up, and it will actually go up and over the roof. So now we're gonna end up with something like an R46 wall. And by adding that 5 inches of exterior insulation, we're gonna end up moving the dew point outside of our sheathing, which means we're not gonna need an interior vapor retarder, which is huge, because now we don't have to worry about installing this service cavity wall after the membrane goes up. We can put it in with framing. As I grab this, I realize that we get some bowed stud. All of this gets corrected in the field. I think that's a critical thing to point out. A lot of people are ask questions about, well, how accurate is panelizing, or what's the benefit of panelizing? Is it perfect? Is there anything in the field that you have to address? Of course there is. But the ability to build this in a factory set type setting, there's so many advantages of it. And dealing with stuff like this, this is just going to be quality control, and you're going to deal with this if you were framing it on site anyway. So a few of these studs being out of whack, those will get taken out, replaced, and we'll be right where we need to be in terms of tolerance. But what this is actually able to do is give us that uninterrupted, thermally broken wall, fully insulated, and then use this as a service cavity to get our electrical, our plumbing, anything that needs to go up and down in the wall outside of our structural wall and into the service cavity, which, if we did have a membrane, prevents the penetration of membrane, but being that we don't, it also prevents the chance that we're gonna run into structural headers and working around that. It's there just to help get utilities up and down. Again, standing in the kitchen, looking back, into the first floor, these guys are moving along. Big shout out to Koopman Lumber, because without someone that can understand the complications of working on a tight site, it would be a mess out there. They worked directly with Cape Cod Panel, so they were able to service their facility and continue to service the site here and make sure that we're getting our quality materials at a pace that we need, and have an understanding of when we need them, where we need them, and how do we get them on site as efficiently as possible, especially when we're dealing with a tight site like this. Really exciting progress, so stay tuned.